The revelation of Helaena's insights into the future of her family has made her into the latest confirmed dragon dreamer in a long line of Targaryens who seem to have some ability to see into the future. Clearly, this is a significant facet in the magical lineage of one of the most important families in the world of Ice and Fire, and their consistent access to prophecy has undeniably been a driving force behind a great deal of their journey. However, the Targaryens are far from the only oracles that exist in Planetos, and given the overall state of magic within this world, it sort of begs the question as to whether these divinations are divinations at all. One of the most interesting aspects of the magic in the world of Ice and Fire is that while it takes on many forms and seems to be used and expressed in different ways, connective threads between these seemingly disparate forms of power consistently seem to emerge. For instance, although the forms of blood magic vary wildly from one edge of the planet to the other, the fact that blood and death can be converted to magical power is an invariable truth in every form of magical practice that has been revealed within the story thus far. Similarly, although the Targaryens have a multitude of dragon dreamers within their lineage, there are a great number of people in the world of Ice and Fire who are either capable of or have access to some kind of prophecy. From Melisandre to Maggie the Frog and everywhere in between, there are plenty of characters who can see visions that seem to be related to the future. But one particular aspect of the magic that exists within the world of Planetos makes the actual nature of these prophecies more questionable and more interesting. Although the true nature and importance of these abilities were never revealed in Game of Thrones and have yet to be revealed in A Song of Ice and Fire, the discovery that Hodor became Hodor as a result of Bran Stark's ability to time travel was a cataclysmic game changer for this entire fictional universe. The fact that Bran was capable of connecting with Hodor in the past in a way that seemingly connected Hodor to his future is an enormous twist that has to be relevant for a much larger reason than just Hodor. But given the fact that time travel exists within the series, the natural question that follows is what it actually means and how it has impacted the world in other ways. There is, of course, a significant possibility that the prophecies in the world of Ice and Fire are in no way magically or thematically connected with the concept of time travel. But given the way that time and space travel seems to function within the story itself, at least from what we've been able to see in Bloodraven or Bran's connections with the past or other places in the world in both Game of Thrones and A Song of Ice and Fire, it doesn't seem very implausible that the characters who receive visions are also experiencing what is essentially the disconnection of their consciousness at the present moment, and the movement of that consciousness into a different time or place within the timeline. Obviously, the counterargument to this notion that characters who are having visions are actually traveling throughout time is the realism of their experiences. Bran and Bloodraven can travel through the Weirwood network and experience literal reality. What they see is actually what happened, and nothing more or less than that. While visions like dragon dreams obviously are as dreamlike and dragonlike as they would be expected to be, everything that these prophetic characters see seems to be symbolic and pretty confusing, and while there appears to be a sprinkling of reality woven into these dreams, almost everything is metaphorical and often literally cannot exist in the real world. And on that basis alone, it would seem that visions and time travel experiences are not the same thing, even if they share some interesting connective threads. And even if there must be some temporal anomalies happening in order for these characters to be seeing things that are either happening in a different place or are literally happening in the past or future. But once again, Bran's adventures in the Weirwood network seem to offer some potential insight into the gulf between prophecy and time travel. Another commonality that seems to exist between traveling through time and seeing visions is that there is oftentimes some kind of conduit used to access whatever it is that the seeker wants to see. In the case of Helaena Targaryen, it seems like these visions come naturally. But many other magic users utilize some sort of magical conductor, such as the worshippers of R'hllor who use fire, or Carthian warlocks who use Shade of the Evening to see what they seek or amplify their abilities. Obviously, there are plenty of magical tools such as these that are a significant presence within the story, but Shade of the Evening is of particular interest when it comes to the possibility of divine visions actually being some kind of time travel, or at least an experience that exists on the same spectrum as time travel. Although Shade of the Evening hasn't been an enormous presence within the world of Ice and Fire as of yet, It seems to present one of the most intriguing clues regarding the connection between prophetic visions and mental time travel. Very little has actually been explored about Shade of the Evening thus far, but one of the descriptions of this magical potion really stands out once you catch the likely reference hidden within it. Shade of the Evening is described as a liquid that constantly changes in flavor and tastes like everything. When Daenerys imbibes it in the House of the Undying and sees an endless assault of visions, she describes the taste in a very vivid and bizarre way. In A Clash of Kings, Daenerys 4, she says, "The first sip tasted like ink and spoiled meat, foul. But when she swallowed, it seemed to come to life within her. She could feel tendrils spreading through her chest, like fingers of fire coiling around her heart. And on her tongue was a taste like honey and anise and cream, like mother's milk and Drogo seed, like red meat and hot blood and molten gold. It was all the tastes she had ever known, and none of them." Now, clearly it could just be a nod to one of the most iconic science fiction stories of all time, but the characterization of Shade of the Evening sounds incredibly close to the description of Spice Melange in Frank Herbert's Dune. Spice Melange is also said to taste like everything and never taste the same twice. And spice is a mind-altering drug that can allow the user to see different aspects of time and space, which is a significant reason why long-distance space travel is even achievable within the Dune universe. This could just be a sneaky reference to a beloved story, so it's not something that an entire theory can be based off of. But again, the notion of these conduits of visionary exploration and time travel is an interesting connective thread that presents some intriguing further possibilities as well. Bringing things back to Helaena, she is actually an interesting case in the sense that her ability to see the future seems unprompted. But what makes it even more interesting is that her foresight seems to be presently limited to her own perspective. Meaning, although she is seeing things that haven't happened yet, she is seeing events like Aemon's mutilation, the Dance of the Dragons, or Maelys's appearance at Aegon's coronation, which are all things that she will actually experience or have knowledge of herself at some point. Essentially, her prophecies are easier to understand because even if her consciousness is capable of seeing beyond her present experience, she is seeing things that will exist in her reality at some point. So in contrast, other dragon dreamers like Daenerys, Aegon I, Daenerys, and even Viserys I with his dream about Aegon's coronation after his death, were seeing things that they did not, would not, and could not experience firsthand. They allegedly had visions of events that they would not be witness to and oftentimes saw things that wouldn't even happen in their lifetime. But Bran and Bloodraven's adventures in the Weirwood Network might offer an explanation for this as well. Essentially, what we see with Bran's experience with Hodor, or with his experiences where Ned seems to hear him in the past, is that magic users who can see different times and places via these magical conduits are actually capable of interacting with whatever they are seeing, at least in some cases. So an interesting question then becomes, have we ever seen interactions like this from the other side? As far as we know, yes. At least in one major instance, we have seen communication on the receiver's end of these magical pipelines when Bloodraven was seeking out Bran. And of course, it seems incredibly meaningful that Bloodraven was consistently communicating with Bran, but Bran's experience and understanding of what was happening was filtered through his own consciousness and subconscious in very weird, dreamlike ways. And it is very hard not to notice that Bran's dreams early on in the story seem to share some thematic similarities with dragon dreams. Even beyond that, it is interesting that basically every dragon dream that is in the narrative includes information that completely changes the course of House Targaryen's journey. Whether it's Daenerys avoiding the Doom, Aegon invading Westeros, or Dany hatching her dragons, these prophecies have a cataclysmic effect on what happens to the Targaryens. These characters aren't always seeking prophecy, nor do they oftentimes even know what to look for to set them on their path. But their dragon dreams seem to push them in the exact direction that they need to go. So it isn't very hard to believe that there is someone potentially pushing them. Undeniably, this theory requires more than its fair share of tinfoil. However, there are some interesting thematic connections to be made. And this potentially adds an interesting facet to the entire history of House Targaryen. If they are somehow predisposed to be capable of moving their consciousness throughout space and time, which seems incredibly likely given that Bloodraven is capable of doing this to the greatest extreme that exists within the world of Planetos, then many of the Targaryens' beliefs about their own destinies becomes more compelling and more believable. The fact that, out of every Targaryen who gets caught up in the dance, Helaena is the one who seems to be cursed with the gift of prophecy, adds an especially tragic element to this ability and its manifestation within the Targaryen bloodline. As far as dragon dreamers go, she seems to be one of the most powerful, as she doesn't need any catalyst like Shade of the Evening or the Weirwood Network in order to facilitate her ability to see what's coming. And it seems like she doesn't even have to be asleep in order to access these dragon dreams. It's interesting that, from that point of view, there is a significant chance that she could be one of the most powerful, if not the most powerful, visionary in House Targaryen's bloodline. It's also heartbreaking that while Helaena seems to be truly extraordinary and distinguished, even within two especially powerful magical lineages, the Targaryens and the Hightowers, her prophecies have no impact on the catastrophic war that develops between them. In a sense, her exceptional abilities could ultimately demonstrate the futility of prophecy in the world of Ice and Fire. Visions don't typically have positive connotations within the story, and the fact that Helaena can seemingly see what's to come but can't do anything to stop it seems like a potential hint that although the dragon dreamers may be able to see fragments of their future, they may also be completely incapable of changing it. But what do you think? Could the dragon dreams that have haunted many Targaryens for centuries be somehow connected to the time travel that other characters in the world of Ice and Fire seem to be capable of? Leave your comments and opinions below. And if you're interested in more content like this, like and subscribe.